Hello and welcome everyone. In this video tutorial, we will understand how we can create a SQL Server trigger on a view. So in some of our previous tutorials, we have discussed how we can create a trigger table in SQL Server. However, we can also create a trigger on a view type object. Now we will start off this video tutorial by discussing, can we create a trigger on a view in SQL Server? After this, we will discuss the syntax example. And in the last, we will discuss another type of variant, that is how we can define an after trigger on view. Now, before we jump to the very first topic, I would like to tell you that we bring such tutorials on regular basis. So if you really like our video, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. Now, without any further delay, let's jump to the very first topic. And let's understand this question, that can we create a trigger on view in SQL Server? Now, in our previous video tutorials, we have seen we usually create a trigger on a table. And the trigger fires based upon the operation that we are performing on a table. For example, we create a trigger for insert operation, update operation, delete operation. But can we create a trigger on a view in SQL Server? So the answer to this question is yes. A trigger in SQL Server is a special kind of store procedure that executes automatically based upon various database events. Now, out of these three kinds of triggers, DML triggers are quite common. DML triggers in SQL Server are triggers that are activated when we try to edit data using DML, that is data manipulation language event. Now the DML events in SQL Server includes the use of insert, delete and even update operation either on a table or on a view. But please note this, while defining a DML trigger in SQL Server, we can either create a for after trigger or an instead of trigger. But we cannot define a for after trigger on a view. So for a view, we have only one option related to trigger, that is instead of trigger. Now let us move to the next topic and let's discuss how we can define this instead of trigger on a view. So we will start off by defining the create trigger statement. Then we need to specify the name of the trigger. Then we will use the on keyword. And then we need to specify the name of the view. After this, we need to use the instead of option. And with the instead of option, we can specify the operation that is about insert, update or delete. And then we need to define the body of the trigger. So what will happen when we define an instead of trigger? The trigger will perform the specified operation instead of this specified condition. That what will happen when we define an instead of trigger in SQL Server? So it will perform the specified operation under the body of the trigger. Instead of performing the insert, update or delete operation, we can understand this thing better with the help of an example. So let us discuss an example related to how we can define a trigger on view. So here I have opened my SQL Server Management Studio, and in this I have several databases out of which I am going to use the GeoNames data. So in the GeoNames database, I have certain tables, for example, countries, state, and there is country log as well. So what I will do, I will first create a view, because we need to create a trigger on a view. So first I will create a view, and what I am doing to create this view, this is the name of the view that I am going to create, that is get USA state. So what I am doing, I am fetching the state name from the state table and the country name from the countries table, and we are only fetching those records whose country ID is 2. So basically the country ID is 2 for United States. So what we are doing by defining this view, we are fetching the state names with their country name for all the states that comes under the United States of America. Let me execute this and let me show you the view as well. So if I write select string from, so this is the result of this view. Now, as I told you, if I try to perform the insert operation on this view, so for example, if I type insert into this, where first is the state name, then the country name. Let me execute this. Now if I try to perform this inserts operation on a view, in that case I will get an error, because we are getting multiple columns from multiple tables and we are trying to perform on this on both of the tables using the same view, which is not possible. So what we will do in such cases, we will create an instead of trigger on a view. So instead of performing the insert operation on the view, what the trigger will do, it will perform the insert operation on the states table, because the state names are coming from the states table. So here is the code for the trigger. So we have named this trigger as trigger USA states, and we are creating this trigger on the view. The type of the trigger is instead of insert, What this instead of insert trigger will do, it will first fetch the country ID and check if the country ID is null or not. If the country ID is valid, then it will perform the insert operation on the states table using the country ID and the name that we have specified in the insert operation. Now we are able to fetch the values using the inserted magic table, and in the last, the insert operation will be performed on the states table. Let me click on execute. This will create our trigger. And once the trigger has been created, what we will do, we will perform the insert operation again on the view. But this time, what will happen, instead of getting the error, the trigger will be initialized. It will first fetch the country ID, then it will perform the insert operation on the states table. Let me execute this. Now if I check the view, here you can see the record has been inserted successfully. So with this, you have understood how we can create instead of trigger on a view in SQL Server. Now let's move to the next topic and let's understand how we can create an after trigger on view. So now this is one of the very frequent questions related to creating a trigger on a view, that how we can create an after trigger on a view. Now I would like to tell you that in SQL Server, we cannot create an after trigger on a view. For trigger and after trigger, both are not supported. For view, we can only create instead of triggers on view. Even if we try to create an after trigger on a view, the SQL Server instance will return an error. Let me show you that. So here you can see one simple example where I'm using the create alter trigger statement and I'm trying to create the trigger on the view. This time I have specified after it and I'm simply using a simple print statement. Now if I try to execute this, the SQL Server will tell the object does not exist or it is an invalid operation that we are going to perform. So we cannot basically create an after or for trigger. Let's check for for as well. Let me execute this, and for also I'm getting the same error. So what is the solution for this? We need to create an instead of trigger on the view. Instead of trying to create an after insert operation, we need to create an instead of trigger. And we have already seen how we can create an instead of trigger on view. Moreover, there is a separate video that we have done related to instead of triggers in SQL Server. You can also watch that. And with this, we have come to the end of this tutorial session where we have learned how we can create a trigger on a view. So if you really like this video, you can press the like button and you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel for more tutorials like this. Thank you so much for watching this video, and here are some more suggestions from our side that you can watch. Thank you.